Mr. Speaker, Hajj is encompassing in its nature and with real state of servitude of the oneness of the Almighty Allah, in the sense that it has all the elements of the other pillars of Islam in it. For instance, testifying that there's no deity worthy of worship but Allah, and testifying that Muhammad, may peace be upon him, is a servant and messenger of Allah, is one of the fundamentals of Hajj, which in essence is the first pillar of Islam. Observing Salah in every aspect of Hajj is the second pillar, and sacrificing by slaughtering the prescribed animal for Allah during Hajj is a core of Zakat, which in essence is the third pillar. And fasting off all prohibitions that guard one's Hajj is a fourth pillar. And Hajj as a fifth pillar, which in real sense summarizes all the pillars of Islam. Mr. Speaker, given the significance of Hajj, it is important for government to take steps to make Hajj costs affordable to Muslims. Cost of Hajj this year in Ghana is one of the highest in the sub-region, of approximately 75,000 Ghana cedis, a dollar equivalent of 6,500, an increment by approximately 100% from last year. This has led to less patronage of Hajj this year, while others have found alternative routes, including going through our neighboring countries, such as Nigeria, Togo, and Burkina Faso, to be able to embark on this very important spiritual journey. Mr. Speaker, Hajj education is also necessary in the country, as many people who undertake Hajj are not properly educated on the principles, guidelines of Hajj. Very aged people still force themselves through the process and end up not having the energy to perform the Hajj. Mr. Speaker, Hajj board should be devoid of political interference in order to give them the freedom and independence to perform their functions. Political interference heavily affects the activities of Hajj and goes a long way to mar its effectiveness. Mr. Speaker, Hajj indeed is a source of salvation to mankind, and I therefore call upon the Hajj board and all relevant stakeholders to do more to reduce the cost of Hajj, as well as ease the burden of Muslims who avail themselves to this important spiritual journey. In my candid opinion, I trust that Hajj plays a significant role in developing people into constructive citizens and not spectators.